school like all my life, since kindergarten to now. I attend Life Church on Usamavi, and this is my testimony. So all my life I've been involved in Catholic lifestyle, attended Mass every Sunday, went to Catholic school since kindergarten, and was always remembered by my parents to thank God for what I have. I remember one of the first things I learned to do was the sign of the cross, even before I even learned to speak English. But despite these things, I still failed to trust in God and forget His great love for me. This struggle of complete faith is something I have been struggling with on and off for 7 years. It was especially hard when changes in my once consistent routine started taking place. Missing church for a week turned into months, then to years. Entering high school, my once natural academic abilities were not the same that I had in middle school, leading to endless anxiety. The image I once had of marriage negatively changed alongside with the example I have at home. With all this, I felt like God wasn't there. I prayed and prayed for some change, but because I didn't see any instant change, I thought He wasn't there. I needed Him back into my life, and I didn't have that connection back until my sophomore retreat here. It was our first retreat with them at Streets. They guided us through games and worship activities, but it wasn't until the end, in the chapel, until I truly felt God. Once we got into the chapel, we each received a sheet of paper. Written on there was kind of like a set of reminders of that God was there and He's kind of in your life. It reminded me that I'm God's child and we're all special. It also had scriptures of motivation and a reminder of God's forgiveness. I honestly don't know why, but I felt so moved by the words. I started crying, which is weird for me since I'm typically the kind to bottle up my emotions. But I suppose God's presence is worth sharing. After this initial moment, I proceeded to go to one of the ministry groups to pray for some of the struggles I had. As I spoke, I started to cry again. This was the first time I had truly spoken to someone about my personal life, but because I knew these words would be heard by God, I simply let myself go. This small but simple prayer played a big moment in my faith, and I felt a sense of physical relief as if God literally took a weight off my shoulders. And who knows, maybe He did. After this retreat, I could say I was more aware and prouder of my faith. About a year later, my junior year, I confessed my sins for the first time since 8th grade. This was another major step in my walk towards God. I needed to start over and get rid of the spiritual weight holding me down so that I could be new again. As I went through these moments, I felt closer and closer to God, of course, still having my setbacks here and there. Going forward, a few months to this past summer when I had my campus core team retreat, we had discussions about how striving for holiness and several opportunities to connect one-on-one with God in the chapel. Our times in the chapel were very special to me because I truly got to speak with God and felt His presence there. It was an honest and fulfilling time, and it gave me time to think about my relationship with Him. And I was blessed to connect with people that I've never met before and got to connect with how similar we were in our faith and our want and need for a better relationship with God. 2 weeks later, I was invited by a friend to attend church with them. I went and I absolutely loved it. The environment there was extremely joyful and really put you in the right mood to pray with the Lord. I truly don't know if I would have ever taken the initiative to attend church again, but I'm extremely grateful to have someone reach out to me and help me get back on my feet again to attend church. And because of them, I have been doing better in attending church. Now, of course, I'm still not a perfect Catholic. Who knows if even such a thing exists? I still struggle to pray every day. I sin, but maintaining a relationship with God is something I will never take for granted again. I know that He's what's best for me, and only He can bring me true happiness. So I reach out to all of you. Think about those little things. Take 5 minutes every day to pray for your friends, family, even those people you don't like. Invite a friend to church. Never forget God died on the cross so that He can and will forgive our sins. It's never too late to have a fresh start with God. I kind of want to leave off with a really important Bible verse, Isaiah chapter 41, verse 10. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand.